Hi, Derek. The European Central Bank recently holding interest rates, suggesting that they are waiting on more data before making any monetary policy moves, although we did see a dip in headline inflation. Dip in headline inflation, recent inflation numbers coming out of Canada for the month of June, pretty much prompting a broad call that we would see a cut courtesy of the Bank of Canada end of July. Your thoughts?
I think another quarter point rate cut is broadly expected for the Bank of Canada on Wednesday. It's priced into the markets, pretty much entirely priced, maybe a basis point or two away from a full quarter point, and most within consensus expect them to cut again. I think they have pivoted to being more forward-looking in terms of wanting to get ahead of the sustainable achievement of 2% inflation that they expect to arrive into next year. And so that therefore they're cutting in a bit of a preemptive fashion in that forward-looking sense. They're less focused upon the most recent inflation data. If they were more adherent to that recent inflation data, then I think they would probably be a little bit concerned by the fact that some of their core measures are still hot in a month-over-month sense over the past couple of months.
Let's get into that, unpack some of those numbers for us. And we know that shelter is still a bit of a sticky component there.
You know, the last 2 months have seen their preferred trimmed mean and weighted median core measures of inflation come in at 4.1% month over month at an annualized pace 2 months ago, and almost 3% in the latest month. These are not light figures. And so we seem to have bounced back from about a 4 month soft patch that we had earlier in the year on those two gauges. And that might reflect the dissipation of some temporary influences that were dragging down inflation at the start of the year. I don't think the Bank of Canada is going to be overly concerned about that just yet. If they get more evidence that this is going to persist over the rest of the year, that might give them some reason to pause and be a little bit more careful. But I think they'll want to have a lot more data in order to get a little bit more nervous. So next week, a quarter point is baked in.
Derek, when you and I last spoke mid-spring, you had suggested that we would see a 75 basis point rate cut by the end of the year. Let's talk about Canada's economy and what it's going to take when it comes to interest rate relief. We know you've got mortgage renewals around the corner. What should that policy rate end up looking like?
We forecast the Bank of Canada to cut by a full percentage point this year, including the June rate cut. And so by the end of this year, we should have a policy rate at 4% compared to the 5% peak, and additional cutting next year. That's already largely baked into measures like the five-year Government of Canada bond yield, which is a big driver of the five-year fixed mortgage rate in Canada in terms of how it gets priced. And so we're at about 3.3% on that five-year bond yield right now. I think that's about as low as it's going to get. So as long as the bank delivers upon our forecast, it's done about as much as it can to help out fixed rate mortgage borrowers in Canada. We've already gone through all of the variable rate mortgage resets in Canada. Most of the fixed rate resets are still ahead of us this year, the year after, and a little bit the year after that. And so they'll be refinancing into a higher environment compared to the mortgages when they took them out, but lower borrowing costs than they would have faced if they had to reset last fall, because we've seen bond yields come down in anticipation of these rate cuts.
The International Monetary Fund recently suggested that Canada has achieved a soft landing. Do you agree with this statement?
I think we're definitely in a soft landing. Scotiabank Economics has always been in the soft landing camp for the Canadian economy. We had 3% quarter over quarter consumption growth in inflation adjusted terms in each of the past two quarters. That suggests that there's enough strength elsewhere in the consumer sector to offset some of the challenges like mortgage rate resets. And so we're getting that soft landing. We're still getting a relatively tight labor market, still getting decent wage gains going forward. More of my concern is whether or not, as we go into 2025, the Bank of Canada will truly be able to achieve its 2% inflation target. I think there's more upside than downside risk to that inflation number as we go off into next year. We need to monitor that. I don't think that's going to stop them from short-term rate cuts, But if I'm right and you do see the reemergence of upside risk to inflation, it could give them a little bit of reason to pause and be a little bit more careful as we go off into next year.
Lastly, inflation is easing south of the border, possibly opening the door to interest rate cuts courtesy of the Federal Reserve. Let's talk about the risks to our loonie and how the Bank of Canada can avoid the Canadian dollar becoming a casualty.
We have the Federal Reserve cutting in September. We think that they'll make enough progress by then. We have a slowing U.S. economy. We have a pickup in terms of some of the population growth and productivity trends in the United States that lessen some of the inflationary pressures. And so I think they're going to want to start to experiment in cutting from the very restrictive stance that they have now. And 50 points worth of cuts by the end of this year from the Federal Reserve. And the Bank of Canada needs that. There is a limit to the extent to which the Bank of Canada can front run the Federal Reserve and undercut the policy rate of the Federal Reserve. And so if they don't get their big brother or big sister coming along and helping them along this path, then I think it could thwart the prospects for further Bank of Canada rate cuts as we go off into next year, because I don't think that they would be comfortable with unmooring the Canadian dollar and a much weaker Canadian dollar. I think something like the low to mid 140s on a USD CAD basis would start to make them a bit more nervous. And so that's roughly another 5 to 10% depreciation in the currency. That's, I think, would be their limit.